Sunday, guys, and thank God it's Sunday! Wala kong it's, kasi nawala yung S, di masyado narinig. It's Sunday, kasi nga mayroon akong retainer, hindi ko pa natatanggal. Ang aga ko nagising, 8:30 ba naman? Tapos, yun, lalang. Nagising lang ako, tapos bumaba ako kasi hinanap yung resibo ng ano. Ito yung mga binayaran ko, yung Globe, Meralco, tsaka Signal. Kala ko na misplace ko, kaloko na sa kotse pala. Imagine yung bumaba agad ako, nag-bihes, nag-bra, nag-shorts, ano yun, biglaan. Sino ako makasleep, kaya okay lang. Tatry kong mag-film later. Sana hindi ako tama rin. Pwede rin naman ako dito mag-lunch kasi may lumpia pa si mama. Hindi ko pa na luluto yun. Baka yun na lang ulamin ko. Tapos mag-white rice na lang muna ako. Wala kasi kaming yung tawag dito, yung microwave oven. Tama ba yung tawag? Microwave oven. Kaya hindi ako makabili ng rice. Tapos iinit na lang. Tsaka pambibili rin ako. Saan ko naman ilalagay yun? Pero affordable lang daw ata yung microwave eh. Kaya lang iisipin ko pa kung bibili ako nun. Para if ever mag-avail kami nung sa lunchbox diet next week, diba? Kung mag-avail kami nun, init-init na lang ng food. Kano na lang gagawin namin if ever. So, ayun lang. And mamaya na lang. Mamaya na ako chika, wala pa ako sa ulirat, guys. Sobrang, hindi ako yata makakapunta sa friend ko kasi sa Das Marinas daw yung venue nung binyag ng inaanak ko. Galing yun sa Japan. Nakamit nyo na yun si Veronica. Last year ba siya dumating dito? Hindi ko maalala kung last year ata yun or basta alam ko na-meet nyo na siya. Kasama yung anak niya si Gina, napakagwapong Japanese. Kaya lang kahapon, hindi nga ako nakapunta kasi ang aga. Hiwalay kasi yung sa simbahan, tsaka yung reception. Kaya, parang alanganin. Basta, hala na guys, mamaya na lang ulit ako mag-chika sa inyo.
Nakatulog ulit ako, kaloka. Kakatanggal ko na nung retainer ko. Nakatulog ako, kakain muna. Wala na pala akong oats, so kakain muna ako ng eggnog, tsaka vitamilk.
Hi guys! Ayan, nakapag-ayos na ako. Baka mag-headband na lang ako kasi nakita ko na to. Finally, nakita ko na yung... Diba, ang tagal-tagal nito. Buti hindi pa siya talaga nawawala. And naisip ko sa liit ng bahay naman, imposible hindi ko siya makita, diba? Ayan, yung headband kong binili. Nakalimutan ko kasi hindi ko ito binili. Anyway, grabe, sobrang init. Makeup ko yung Laura Mercier na foundation. And then Anastasia na ang contour kit, tapos sobrang, as in, sobrang ganda, guys. Talagang masasabi ko, teka lang, wait lang. Ang ganda nitong blush on na to. Wait lang. Yung hair ko. Ayan, itong Physicians Formula. Kasi sa picture, may kakaibang glow siya. Ibang-iba talaga siya. Ang ganda. And gamit ko sa eyeshadow ko itong Neutral Eyes 28 Color Eyeshadow Palette from It's All Girly Cosmetics, BH Cosmetics siya. Ayun, sobrang ang ganda rin. And pinaghalo ko yung three colors, medyo light. Wait na. Mahirap i-explain. Essential na yung fan maingay. Itong color, itong violet na yan. Saka itong dark. Pinag-combine ko na lang. Ayan, basta bahala na. And then, yung binigay sa akin ni Beb Maria na mascara na black from Essence. Maganda siya kasi talagang waterproof. And then yung Minaw Kiss Proof Matte Lipstick number 14 yung bigay sa akin ni Ate Cherry. And then sa kilay ko, yung Rimmel Pencil and then yung Naked. Wala lang. Try ko lang na ganito lang siya. Pero parang makapal to. Hindi ko alam. Basta bahala na. Okay na yan. And gamit ko yung bigay ni Beb Jaja na necklace and then yung top. Matagal na itong binigay sa akin itong necklace. Siguro 2 years ago. Ngayon ko lang nagamit kasi bagay siya dito. And simple lang. And then, naka-leggings lang ako. Basta mamaya na lang, naglalagay pa ako ng watch ko. So, wait na lang. Plinlunch ako ng konti yung buhok ko para medyo straight naman siya. Kanina, sobrang buhag-hag, kaloka. Pero nilagyan ko na ito nung oil na binigay sa akin ni Sis Hiroko. Kaya medyo okay-okay na siya.
So, ngayon naman, ano ba? Punta muna ako ng LBC kasi may papadala rin ako money doon. Tapos, gora na sa Alabang. Ay, retainer ko pala. Grabe, lifesaver talaga tong ano, fan na to. Sobrang ingat pagdating ko sa kotse, as in. And, pupunta pala muna ako ng SM ng Globe kasi may kailangan pa akong bayaran na 200 plus sa bill ko. Kasi 3,000 lang binayaran ko, may 200 pa pala, so kailangan kong bayaran. Punta na ako doon and then doon na lang ako mag-lunch sa SM. Busog pa ako kasi kumain ako ng eggnog, tsaka corn, tsaka Vitamilk. Ang lakas talaga makabusog ng Vitamilk, as in. Kaya yun, alis muna ako guys. So, later na lang. Ayan, pag Sunday talaga wala masyadong traffic. Yun lang, mukhang puno yung parking ngayon dito. Tignan nyo naman. Good luck naman sa akin. Grabe guys, so kamusta naman ang parking nito? Sobrang daming parang sobrang daming kotse. Siguro ano na ako, didiretso na lang ako sa ano, sa Festival Mall. May Globe naman din doon. Doon na lang din ako kakain dahil ang init din kung maglalakad ako dito. Parang hindi ko rin kakayanin talaga. Sobrang daming tao. Nalabas na ako dito. Festival na lang ako. At least mag-ikot-ikot pa ako doon. Or mag-ano na lang ako mag-aantay ng ano, ng Globe kung ayoko na dito, ka-lurks. Yan, buti na lang walang traffic ngayon, kaya okay lang siya. Festival na ako. Grabe, 20 minutes ako bago nakahanap ng parking, literal. Ganun ka tagal. Ang daming tao dito, ultimong gilid na na-parking na. Grabe, but thank God nakahanap ako ng isa. $46 ako. Ito na yung ano, yung meal. $145. Tama ba? Pag gusto ko kumain dito, ay $140 lang pala siya. So, yan. Yan, tapos na ako kumain. Punta muna ako sa Robinsons or H&M na lang muna. Titingin din ako ng mga pwedeng ipang gift kay Heinz. Kaya lang, ayun ko, kung may mabibili pa ako. Kasi yung sa Uniqlo hindi siya nakabili kasi walang size niya. I mean, iba na yung fit ng mga t-shirts sa Uniqlo last time kaya hindi ako nakaano, hindi siya nakabili. So, tignan ko siya sa H&M kung okay.
This is why I believe that this wisest man on earth, okay, and this richest man on earth, okay, no other than King Solomon, is similar to really how Shaquille O'Neal started. But the problem with this man is that there was something that he was not unaware that has cost his kingdom. Last week we talked about day, not just a wise choice, because a lot of us here, I believe, that you love God, am I correct? You came here to listen to God's word, and you want to have a relationship with God. But the problem is that if we love God, there is a possibility that as we go about life, that we would want to entertain other things. This is what happened to King Solomon. He loves God alongside with other gods. This is where we get into trouble. That if you love God, it is God and God alone who deserves our worship. But there is a possibility that yes, we have a relationship with God, but we're willing and we are at times willing, or should I say, we at times are accommodating other gods other than the God of the universe. This is why I believe that Solomon is posed for success, because before he started his reign in Jerusalem, he received his advice from what? He received an advice from his father. And the name of his father is King?
David.
King what?
David.
King?
David.
This is what happened to Solomon. So I want you right now to open the... And the reason why he deviated from the purposes of God, because he was led astray by the love of his life. He was devoted to God, but there was something that really caught his attention. This is how it all began. Solomon made a marriage alliance with Pharaoh, king of Egypt. He took Pharaoh. So what really happened here was not his intention that he doesn't want to fellowship with God. His intention was not to cut ties with the Lord. He wants God in his life. But the only problem that we need to always recognize in the life of Solomon, that he included and he affiliated himself with a woman. Okay? That he should not be affiliated with. In verse 4, what God is asking from him. He can dive into the whole idea that he wants something from God, and yet he looked back and thanked the Lord for how the Lord established the what? The kingdom of David. In verse 7, that we have this kind of opportunity, we will always think for the things that we want in life. Am I correct? Yeah. This is why it is important that we can glean and take a closer look into that when we are asked by God, always remember this, that you ask God not for just for things for your own consumption, that you ask God to be a blessing to other people. And this is why the Lord blessed him more than wisdom with all the riches, that he was asking God more than just what he wants for himself. That his desire is to rule the kingdom and have a discerning heart. This is why it pleased the Lord that Solomon asked this, and have not asked for yourself long life or riches or the life of your enemies, but have asked for yourself understanding to discern what is right. This was what Solomon wants. Behold, I now do according to your word. Isn't it amazing? Govern your people. I'm for your people. Yes, I want to be blessed, but before you bless me, let me be a blessing to others. I do pray that all of us in this room would have the posture that more than just what we want for ourselves is that we always think of the people around us. Yeah. We will think of the people that God has blessed us with. We will think of our relatives or our family members, our friends. You'll think of the people around you, beside you, and you'll think of me. I'm just kidding. But my point is, Solomon, more than just what he wants for himself, he was simply saying, God, give me wisdom so I can govern your people. And if you take a closer look, God granted discernment and right judgment and everything that God wants to bless him was added after that. Solomon desired for wisdom. In fact, Solomon wrote the book, okay, and the book of Proverbs. And if you take a closer look, and if you're asking me this question, okay, that was asked about a week ago. So how do you define wisdom? It is a bit, in a way, abstract, because there is no specific definition for wisdom. We can define, but the best way to go about knowing what wisdom is to go back to chapter 1 of the book of Proverbs. Isn't it amazing? The first chapter of that book speaks of how and what wisdom is. And that book speaks of the kind of wisdom that goes back to the concept of how we go about instruction. So if you want to grow in wisdom, how many of you here want to grow in wisdom? Yes, you want to grow in wisdom. And the starting point of that is the fear of the Lord. But wisdom in itself is what? A form of instruction. Education through... If you're a type of person that you don't want to be corrected, you will never grow in wisdom. Mm. How many of you here, okay, you're thankful that somebody goes out of his way to correct you? I mean, I can receive correction from people. But every time, I don't know for what reason, every time my wife goes out of her way to correct me, there is something deep within my soul. That is just demonic. Do you understand? If you're married, I don't know why. And that is my struggle. And that is my prayer. I want to listen to my wife. I can listen to a lot of people, but when my wife tells me something that I need to improve, there is something rebellious from deep within my soul that tells me she's wrong and I'm right. But I know that God is using my wife to correct my heart. And I hope that in the same manner, if you want to grow, you want to mature. How many of you here, you want to succeed in life? You want to prosper? Only a few. You want to die poor, right? Come on now. Nobody wants that. So if you can't take heed of instructions and correction, don't aspire to be blessed by the Lord. Part of wisdom is discernment, the ability to see what God sees. At times there's a tendency for us to react, but when you see the way God sees, instead of reacting, you will respond. Am I correct? Same thing with understanding. If you're growing in wisdom, you will grow in understanding, the ability to understand the whys of life. There are so many questions out there, but the answers are so few. Well, no. There's so many whys out there, but if you're reading your Bible, people will be asking so many questions. But deep within your heart, you will explain to yourself that, Lord, I know you're in control. There are certain things that I can't answer, but one thing I know, you're in control. And you can respond in that manner because you have a relationship with God. You can easily understand. That's a man of wisdom. That you'll grow in prudence, the ability to know the dangers before us. There are a lot of clueless people out there that they want to go about certain decisions based on their emotions. Pastor, I'm in love. Yes, I'm telling you right now. Okay? Our emotions are given by the Lord, but you cannot trust yourself when you're so emotional. Hear this loud and clear. You cannot trust yourself when you're emotional. When you're bitter and you make what major decisions, it will be for your own destruction. I mean, if you ask yourself and you evaluate all your decisions in the past, wherein you're emotional, most of these things are the things that got you into trouble. Am I correct? Because again, we listen to what we feel. We have to take the posture of God, that we do it according to the wisdom that God has blessed us with. Knowledge, information that is deeply personal. A lot of us here, we think that as long as I know this subject, I think I have what it takes to make accurate decisions. I'm telling you right now. At the end of the day, if your relationship with God is not right, no matter if you have a master's degree, you have a doctorate degree, you have all the degrees, I'm telling you that you will make wrong decisions. Because if the basis of making right choices is based on your pedigree, okay, and the kind of university you came from, I'm telling you right now, this country would have been once again the tiger of Asia. We have great what? Government officials. But at the end of the day, the problem is not how educated you are. The problem is the condition of your heart. When you are away from God, if you don't have a relationship with God, if you're not wholeheartedly devoted to God, you will make stupid decisions. This is why, okay, I was just reminded that when we did talk about 2 weeks ago of who King Saul is, somebody who doesn't have any heart, no heart at all. When it comes to his relationship with God, no heart at all. About a week ago, we did talk about what? David. A person who is wholehearted. No heart. Whole heart, you know who Solomon is? Half heart. He is half-hearted because he wants God, but he wants to accommodate other gods. He affiliated himself with the Pharaoh's daughter. But the Bible is clear. In fact, it was King who wrote this definition of what wisdom is in Proverbs chapter 9, verse 10. The fear of the Lord, when we fear God. And every time we mention the word fear, there is a negative connotation. The word fear is not something negative. In fact, the word fear means that this is what? This is a picture of God and His holiness. His holy that you tend to run away from, but He is full of love, that He's calling you in. Do you understand? Let me say that once again. That God is holy, that you tend to run away from because you're not holy, but because God is holy and He wants to call you in, you can't help but be in awe of who He is. That's the kind of fear. This is not something that you are what? You're asked to stay away from. This is not the kind of fear. This is the kind of fear that draws you in. That is why the more we experience the holiness of God and the grace of God, you can't help but be amazed that your fear is not from the posture that is holy. Your posture is always, yes, it's holy, but He loves me so much. And if you have that experience, you know what I'm talking about. The more we experience the trembling, awe, and wonder before the greatness of our God, the more that we have a high regard of who He is, thus it causes us to gravitate to Him. There is a type of fear that causes you to run away from God. But this type of fear causes you to gravitate towards God. This is the kind of fear. This is why God gave Solomon wisdom and very great insight. And a breadth of understanding as measureless as the sand of the seashore. Solomon's wisdom, devotion. How many married people in this house? Your husband will tell you, honey, mahal. I'll be available to you 24/7, but 1 minute, except 1 minute a day, I'll be with another woman. Will you allow him to do so? I'm yours 7 days a week, except 1 minute every Sunday, I'll be with this woman. Will you allow that person? You have him 24/7, except 1 minute. Will you allow your husband to be with another woman? Yes or no? Yes. Of course, no. 1 minute, 30 seconds. Why? You have him. Okay, 20 seconds. Why? Because you want his complete devotion. But some of us here, we think we can play and dance with God. God wants our 101%. That He's the Lord of our lives. Amen. This is why, because He entertained other things, He started despising wisdom. Because wisdom tells Him, you're doing what is not pleasing to God. This is why for some of us here, we despise reading the Bible when we are living in sin. How many of you here, you're struggling opening the Bible when you are in sin? You're struggling. You're about to open the Bible, but you can't when you're living in sin. Because the Bible speaks of godly counsel. The reason why you don't want to be in a victory group, the reason why you don't want to expose yourself with godly friends, because you're in sin. But if you want, okay, to start with a clean slate and start all over again and obey the Lord, my challenge to all of us is that we give our 101% to God. Even the greatest gifts and all our talents, we know that God has blessed us with. But without having the right understanding that more than just our wisdom and talents, even the greatest gifts and wisdom, and with everything that God has blessed you with, just like Solomon, if you don't give your all to God, I want to tell you and warn you that you are in for a big trouble. The Bible is clear. Your hands. How many of you here, you want to succeed in life? All of us, right? My advice to you is that you wholeheartedly devote yourself to God, that you don't entertain anyone. In any relationships, even though you are in love with your wife and vice versa, if you entertain something, it can ruin your marriage. Whether that's a picture or a text message, eventually it will ruin your marriage. That's the tool of the enemy. That he would want something to catch up. That if you're not wholly devoted to God, there is always something that the enemy will present as an alternative. So I want us to surrender to God. That if there are certain things that are not right, that we hand it over to God. And we say, God, we want to worship you. We want to give our lives to you. We want to devote our lives for your glory and honor. I want to call the music team.
Ganda ng message today, nakaka-refresh. Parang ganun lang kasi parang, alam mo yun, nag-emote-emote ako kahapon, pero ngayon sobrang na-refresh ang utak ko. And mag-focus, mas maganda talaga mag-focus sa mga positive na bagay at sa mga nagmamahal sa'yo. Kung meron mong mga negang tao or ano man, ilan lang sila, mas pagtutuan natin ang pansin yung mas nagmamahal sa atin. Think positive lang na talaga. Hindi ako masyadong nabusog ka na sa Kenny Rogers, kaya mag-ano ako, mag-greenwich na lang kami. Gusto ko ba nila or magdaw? Ayan, ito yung order ko. Maliit lang na lasagna. Tapos siya pizza and ano yan? Lasagna with something. Ang fries. Ayan guys. Ha? Natry kong mag ano? Mag live chat later. Like 20 minutes na ako. Bahala kung ano. Ano, kamusta?
It's good. And,
tintiis na lang.
At talagang sobrang pabaya ko ngayon sa diet ko. I mean, just eating everything that I want to eat para pagbalik ko, meron ako enough motivation to start burning off those calories. So, but having a night ng wife ko, walang pabayaan.
Pero kung huwag masyado kasi, di ba, hindi rin maganda. Tsaka, nakakaano siya eh, nakaka... Ano may pag hindi ka nga nag-workout, parang feeling mo super tired ka. Wala kang ano, basta lagi iba rin talaga. Kaya ako kahit papano, kahit 1 hour lang, sinisipag ako mag-spinning or basta magpapawis lang. Kasi ayoko talaga yung pakiramdam na since sanay ako everyday, kahit masabi mo naglalakad ako umaga pa lang hanggang gabi, iba pa rin talaga yung pawis mo, as in, iba talaga. So, importante talaga rin mag-workout. Tsaka yun din yung ano ko eh, yun din yung nakakatulong siya sa everyday kong ginagawa. Yung workout, kasi diba, kung saan-saan ako nagpapapadpad, naglalakad, kung everyday. So, nabuboost yung ano ko, yung ano tawag ba doon? Immune system ko rin, syempre. Tsaka nag-vite, importante rin yung vitamins, yun. Lalo na pag sobrang on the go ka. Kaya yun lang. So, dito na dun pa. Layo ng parking ko kanina kasi tagal ko nga nag-antay, sobra. Ayun, dun ako, ayun na. Ayan guys, bahay na kami and ayusin ko na yung mga order. O nga pala guys, sa mga o-order pa, yung mga magbayad kanina tsaka kahapon, bukas ko ipapaship. And then sa mga magbabayad ng Tuesday onwards, baka next shipping ko is Friday. Friday pero yung mga o-order ng mga creams, first come first serve guys. First come, first serve. Sabi na dito na ako sasabi ko. Ayun, first come, first serve, guys. Yung mga creams, toner, kasi limited lang yung meron ako ngayon. And ang next na stock nun is sa katapusan siguro. Or first week na lang, namitim na yun ako. Or first week na ng, ano ba yun? June. Grabe, ang bilis ng araw! Kaya, yun. And thank you so much sa mga nagbayad today. And may mga order bukas. Maraming salamat. Bukas, sobrang busy ako umaga pa lang kasi kailangan kong gawin yung mga errands ko for tomorrow. Dahil nga, magiging busy kami for ilang days ni Heinz. Dahil quality time namin next week hanggang next week. Wait lang. Napagod ako kasi nagbuhat kami ng mga boxes ng soap. So, iba kasi nasa kotse pa. Kaya iba, pinaano namin. Kasi marami-raming order bukas. May hatid pa ako bukas ng mga orders. Kaya kailangan ko ng ayusin. And, ayun. Tapos bukas magpapadala ako sa parapuntang Hong Kong ng 5 triple cream milk lotion. Maganda kasi yung milk lotion. Kasi milk lotion, may instant whitening effect siya. Pero tsaka ako na-explain sa inyo yung mga products ko. Wala ako sa mood mag-explain ngayon dahil pagod na ako. Basta, if ever man, i-viber nyo lang ako or mag-PM na lang kayo sa page. Kung ano man, kung may mga tanong kayo, sasagot ako agad, basta online ako. So, good night guys! Thank you so much for watching. Hindi ko napapakita si Heinz kasi nasa loob na rin and mag-aayos na siya dahil ano oras na? 10 o'clock na. And ako na magpapaalam. So, good night. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. And God bless. I love you all. Thank you so much sa love and support niyo sa amin.